Hola amigos,
Xavier here for Home of the Earth, signing in from San Cristobal, more specifically the hiking area that's behind the orchid garden, which I'll be doing a separate video of. But in this video I'll be covering Mexican cuisine. Mexico is renowned for its delicious cuisine. And in this video, I'm going to be kind of separating the cuisine that I experienced in kind of three large areas that I'm going to kind of combine. So that being northern Mexico, western Mexico, and southern Mexico. What I'm talking about is the traditional cuisine that you see the most. So this, I'm talking about like kind of small villages and just everywhere in general. Obviously, if you're in a big city, then you're gonna have more options than what I'm talking about. I'm talking about what is the most common. Okay, so northern Mexico. So not much vegetation, a lot of meat. So if you're vegetarian, you're going to be eating a lot of refried beans if you're in a small town. So a lot of the restaurants that I frequented typically didn't even have a menu when you're in a small town, so they would just kind of give you some options and you would pick if you were able to understand them, which I wasn't because I was new to Mexico when I was in northern Mexico. So for breakfast, usually you'll have eggs and then with your eggs, so kind of like an omelet or scrambled, you have the choice of chorizo, which is like sausage, maybe some arrachera, so like a steak kind of beef, or chicken, and you might have peppers or onions available, but not always. And then you'll have a side of refried beans, and of course, as with most Mexican meals, tortillas and salsa, of course.
Good old chorizo. Can't go wrong.
So that's for breakfast. For lunch, I would typically have something a little bit similar, but instead of having eggs, I would just have more meat that would usually be drowned in salsa. Again, with the refried beans and tortillas. Usually my pick for my dinner or late night meal, I say late night because Mexicans kind of eat dinner from like 8 to 10, lunch is like 2 to 4, and breakfast is kind of varies wildly, so from like 9 to 12 or something. Just making sure I'm going the right way here. I think I am. Yeah, so tacos, these I would usually get from like a street vendor, usually less than 10 pesos each. And your options would be, again, meats, so pork, chicken, or beef. Sometimes you would even have some pretty interesting cuts of like organs, tongue, brain, and usually with the tacos you would have the choice of cebolla, so onions, cilantro, they call it verdura, and then you'd have usually at least one salsa to choose from. So, although I didn't try the brain tacos, I could say that my favorite, I think thus far, has been El Pastor, which is like a salty pork. And depending where you get it, you might even have some pineapple in there. So, super delicious. Definitely have to check out or try El Pastor if you're in Mexico. Yeah, so that's kind of typically what you can expect in northern Mexico. So not huge variety, but I definitely enjoyed it. My type of food for sure. And I guess kind of a noteworthy thing to mention is in Durango, in terms of cuisine, they're probably best known for gorditas, which is kind of like a taco, but it's like a pocket. So you have the bread and then the food goes inside. And the restaurants that are street vendors that sell gorditas will usually have at least like three different kind of stuffings. So the stuffings could be like, again, chicken, beef, or pork, and then each stuffing would have a different type of seasoning, and then maybe like potatoes or onions or some peppers as well. So my strategy was, when I go to these places, to just try as much of the stuffing and eat as many gorditas as I can. And they're usually pretty small, so it lends itself well to doing that. Okay, so next area would be the West Coast. So I got to bicycle through Sinaloa, Nayarit, and I feel like I'm missing a state here, but regardless, it'll still apply. So this is a more lush environment. So you're next to the ocean, there's more humidity, more plants growing. So this is where you can finally get a salad, if you think your immune system is up for it. If you're new to Mexico, if you're only there for a week or something and you really don't want to get sick, then maybe best to stay away, because salads are one of the kind of main culprits when it comes to getting turista, which is traveler's diarrhea. Yeah, so salad is available, and also lots of seafood, a lot of shrimp, tons of different kinds of fish. Naturally, you're next to the Pacific coast, so you can get fresh fish, which means that you can get it raw, but you can also get it grilled or fried in a fillet, as well in a salad, in tacos, or tostadas. So tostadas are like a flat taco shell, and then you have the food on top, and you eat it kind of like if you're eating a cracker with like cheese on top of it. And this is actually my favorite food I think I've had on the West Coast, or at least seafood, was in San Pancho, Nayarit. So just a little bit north of Puerto Vallarta, where this was street food, where I had I believe it was called ceviche guerrero. So that was a tostada with tuna, onions, carrots, maybe some tomatoes and cheese, and some kind of tangy mayonnaise sauce. And it was absolutely delicious. I ate it many times while I was there. All right, so the next area is going to be central Mexico. So when I was in central Mexico, I was spending a lot of time in kind of bigger towns or big cities. So I was eating a lot of food that, you know, that wasn't really specific to central Mexico. That being said, I was eating a lot of street food, and there were some items that I found were more common in central Mexico, at least for street food, than elsewhere in the country. The first would be tortas. So this is a sandwich that you would typically have like pork or some other kind of meat, onions, tomatoes, avocado, and then some kind of like salty sauce. These are delicious, and their distinctive feature is the really fresh and fluffy bread. So very filling, very delicious. The other item that I saw quite a bit of was tamales. This is kind of an interesting food. It's a corn-based dough, And it does vary, but I'll just explain what I usually saw and ate. So corn-based dough, and then inside there would be a little bit of either pork or chicken, and then you'd have some salsa on the side. So not the most nutritious meal, given that it's pretty starchy, and it comes in a corn husk, so it's steamed. It's pretty good, but again, not the most nutritious, but it is very economical. They're usually like 10 pesos or less, so a great way to fill up for cheap. Okay, so the final region that I'll be covering is southern Mexico. So what this would be is, at least for me, would be Oaxaca, the state of Oaxaca, and the state of Chiapas. So Oaxaca is probably the Mexican state that's the most known for its cuisine. Oaxaca has great coffee, chocolate, cheese, mezcal, which is alcohol that's similar to tequila.
Mucho mezcal.
And forget the name, I think it's chapulines, which is grasshoppers. So that one I have not tried yet. And it's also known for the meal that I probably ate the most in Oaxaca, which is tlayudas, T-L-A-Y-U-D-A-S. So this is like a really big quesadilla. It's usually folded over. I've actually had it where it wasn't folded over. It's kind of crunchy, kind of a crunchy bread. And inside you have refried beans, onions, tomatoes, cheese, beef, avocado, and then on the side you would have salsa. And these things are massive, so great for cycling at the end of the day to eat a tlayuda. Delicious and filling. That does it for Oaxaca. Now for Chiapas. So when I was in the small town of Chiapas de Corzo near Tuxtla Gutierrez, local was nice enough to show me what was kind of the traditional food there. And what it was a soup that had a really good seasoning and onions and really nice marinated pieces of pork. Super delicious.
En la carne de cerdo.
And the drink was called a pozol. So this is a kind of grainy drink that you have to stir and then drink. You have to stir it before taking a sip. And this is made of chocolate and corn. And it was definitely delicious and a great complement to the pork soup that I had.
Se mueve. Se mueve. Ajá. Mira, así.
¿Es pozol?
Sí, pruébalo. Pruébalo.
Es cocho.
Es cochito.
Cochito.
Cochito, comida tradicional de acá, de Chiapas de Corzo. Okay. Y el pozol también es una bebida hecha de masa con cacao, azúcar.
There's a lot more food to be eaten in Mexico for sure. That's what I experienced on my trip. If there's any other kind of Mexican meals that you feel like I missed that are really representative of any area, or if you just want to talk about, you know, what's your favorite Mexican meals, you can leave a comment below or ask a question if you like as well, and I'll definitely check those out. And yeah, and if you want to see kind of a map of everywhere that I went in Mexico, and then the blog posts and videos that I made while I was in that town or city or whatever, you can head over to my website, followthehumoftheearth.com. And if you're interested in following my journey, that is my first bicycle tour from Canada to Argentina, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on the red button below the video. So I hope you enjoyed, hope you maybe learned something, and have a great one.